What do you think? Is it possible to make ready-made projects at the very start of your training as a programmer and receive $500 or more for it? Of course it's possible. My name is Steven. I'm a Python developer with 11 years of experience in the largest IT companies in the world, such as Amazon. And today, in this video, we will develop three simple but very useful projects that you will be able to create all by yourself after watching this entire video.
Fine. I'll do it myself.
Be sure to watch this useful video till the end because these projects are very interesting and widely used. After watching the entire video, you will understand how to do these types of projects, get cool insights and life hacks on writing codes, and understand how to utilize these ready-made projects to your advantage with realistic code examples. I guarantee that the knowledge of such cool projects will allow you to become a highly in-demand IT specialist, and you will be able to start receiving from $3,000 per month and more right in the beginning of your career. By the way, before I forget, on my channel I regularly post videos with mega useful information for programmers who are just starting their path in coding. In my videos I analyze how to make your first money at the start of your career, the main topics in Python language, as well as other useful things that you will need to know to have a long-lasting and successful career in programming. Therefore, in order not to miss out the new video, do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell. Alright, here we go.
Alright, let's start with that, and then try to understand things.
The first project that we will create today is the weather data collector. Yes, again about the weather. In the last video, I gave examples of an umbrella and rain when I talked about conditions and the Python language. In that video, I talked about all the main topics, divided them into categories, and gave examples with an actual code. It turned out very informative and there was nothing extra. These topics will be enough to understand what to start your training in coding and on what aspects of Python you should focus at the beginning of your career. So click on it and start practicing coding right now. Link to the video in the description below. So we are going to start with getting the API. But what is an API? Well, an API is a certain type of data that we need to take from the website of a specific company. In our case, this is weather data. We will take it from the Open Weather website. But first, we need to open the API tab, then click on Sign In and Register on the site. We create an account to prove to the website that we are not a robot.
You are just a machine, an imitation of life.
Unless, of course, you are a robot, Jay, and finally get to the main page. Here we switch to API keys. This is a unique identifier. We will need it so that OpenWeather understands that I'm a normal user and that they can control me using this API key. You absolutely cannot show this key to anyone because it's something like a password. Next, we copy our API key and go to our weather API project. Here we say the following. API key is equal to the string our key. We save our API key to the variable. Go back to the page that you are on and open the API tab again. Choose the current weather because we need to take weather data at this particular moment in time. Click API doc and open the entire description. Amongst many ways to request the weather, we select request by city name in the menu, which means that we will request the weather by the name of the city from the documentation. A few words about what the documentation is. In our case, this is a website that allows you to understand what data you need to get your API in order to get the correct information back. For example, in this case, we need to pass the name of the city, which allows us to understand in which city we want to find out the weather. And an API key is something that allows us to log to this particular information. Let's say it's New York. So here's what we're going to do. We go to request by city name, copy this whole part and go back to the project. Please note, there are two parameters in the URL itself, city and API key. For now, we're going to remove them. We only have a URL that we can change, add paste and it will be the weather for last month. Or leave it as is and it will be the weather now. Then we need to make an HTTP request, and to do this in Python, we need to install the library. Here I will open a really cool thing called the terminal and write the following line. So we got the requests library, which will help us make HTTP requests. So now close the terminal, climb to the top and import this library. And now we are writing the following code. Okay, what have we written here? We say that we have our API key, our identifier, we have an API URL where we need to make a request. And we say, request library, make this request. Take some data from this URL. Our parameters are Q, our city, and our app ID is API key. Accordingly, if we change the parameter from New York to London, then we will get the weather from London. I think everything is clear here, so we can move on.
We must move on. We cannot linger.
Writing weather data equals response.json. Now we have taken all the data only about the weather, and now we can just print it all and then point it to the file. Right click, run. We launch and see that there's a lot of different information in this API. Here we only need the temperature that we have in the main. And now in order to get our temperature, we write main temp. We launch it and see that it's 284 degrees Kelvin in New York right now. So once again, what did we just do? We took the weather from New York. But since you and I want to achieve automation of the process, we need to make sure that we can find out the weather in any city, not just New York. Therefore, we will enter the string before the request, city input. Write your city and put city here. And we also add information to this line. We launch and write any city, London for example, and we see that the temperature in London is also 284 degrees. Now let's try to incorporate another beautiful city, Los Angeles for example, where we will get a completely different temperature. And this is how it works. Now we will look into how to transfer the received data to Celsius. Going back to the API data, we find the units parameter that shows in which units we want to measure our weather in. Then we specify these parameters in our code, for example, Unix metric, run and check. And again, we write New York, press enter, and we see that it's 10 degrees Celsius. Our data has changed because we said we wanted to use the metric system. Oh, great weather for a walk in Central Park. All right. Let's summarize the first project. We create an API key, then an API URL, enter our city, and make a request using request.get. Next, we pass parameters, the city and the key, and also, if necessary, add units. Now we say that of all the information that we need is only about the weather data, and inside this data, we are only interested in the weather at a given time in the city that we're interested in. I think you will understand everything here. The code is not very complicated, not to even mention super useful.
I'm sure they can be useful.
Well, how are you doing? Exhausted from all this new information? By the way, write down in the comments below what is the most difficult part for you in learning Python and why. I will make a separate video on the most asked questions in which I will analyze the topic and help you solve your problem. Yes, sometimes learning programming, especially at the starting stage, can be quite tedious. A lot of new information can be confusing and overwhelming, but there's a solution. An experienced Python master will help structure the training in such a way that you'll be able to easily comprehend and master all of the concepts that I go over in these videos. I've been using and practicing these techniques for more than 10 years. I teach the programming to everyone, especially to students who start their journey literally from scratch. Of course, you can go the whole way of learning programming on your own and spend several years on it. But I'm sure you agree that it's much faster and more convenient when you have an experienced mentor that will guide you through the basics of a programmer's profession and take you step by step to the goal that you have set for yourself. Now, by choosing this path, you will learn coding faster and start earning your first money as soon as your first month of doing it. I'll tell you how to do it in the next video. But if you can't wait, the link is already waiting for you in the description below. All right, let's move on.
Right. Let's go.
Now we'll discuss two more very useful projects, the knowledge of which will be a very cool addition to your ever-growing skill in Python. This means that you will increase your chances of becoming a more in-demand specialist in this field and get your desired job in one of the leading IT companies in the world. Also, keep in mind that it's not necessary to get an office job. That's the beauty of being a programmer. You can write code from anywhere in the world. You can work from home while drinking your favorite almond latte or anything else that you may like to drink while working. You can be just like me, sitting at home in your favorite chair, making your first $500 working as a freelance coder on the Fiverr platform. In fact, there are a lot of ways to make money in programming, and just for you, I have selected the top 5 ways to do it, including but not limited to becoming a blogging coder or teaching coder. All of these potential variations of utilizing what I teach could help you make your own IT company and earn millions of dollars with just programming. This is exactly what my next video is about. So subscribe, click the bell, so you don't miss out on the super useful video. So the second project we'll create today is the YouTube Downloader. Open any video on YouTube, such as MrBeast, share and copy the link. Let's go back to our code and paste the link into this code. Video URL equals our link. The link is now saved in a variable. Let's install the video download library. Go to the terminal and write pip install pytube. Import the library into your project and write yt equals pytube.youtube. We created a YouTube object to download information from it. Now we ask the YouTube object to take the highest video quality out of all possible quality options. To download this video, we write stream.download. Right-click, run, and wait a bit. Well, while we are waiting for the video download, you have time to like my video so that someday I will become as popular as MrBeast. Great! The video download is now complete. Open the folder where we have YouTube Downloader and see our video there. Open it with the right mouse button, open in Explorer, and make sure the video really downloaded. Now you have downloaded video from MrBeast channel on your computer. That's brilliant. Close this window and instead of our link, just type input.write, your video URL. Now we can insert any link to the video and download it. Let's add a line, print video is being downloaded. If I copy any other video, I will click here and paste our video into this line and press enter. The video will start downloading. The video is being downloaded at the moment, so that makes our interface even more user-friendly. Now we wait a little bit. The video is downloaded in the same folder as the previous video. That's actually our second YouTube Downloader project. Not so complicated, right? And it's super useful.
We could really use it.
Now I'll tell you how to create another really cool project. It's the easiest of all three projects, but it's also necessary in your Python coder skills base. But if you want to learn how to create more complicated projects and make your first really big money in the next few weeks, sign up for programming training with me. I use all of my experience as a developer in major IT companies such as Amazon, and I share all of my secrets of the coder profession with my students. Training is based on a single and clear roadmap, no nonsense or useless material. To start learning coding with me, you don't even need basic knowledge in IT, which is perfect for beginners. The link to the training is in the description to the video. So hurry up and start your way in IT today. Let's start creating our third project. The password generator. Even though it is relatively easy, it has some important aspects that I wouldn't recommend skipping, so be sure to watch this video carefully until the end. We write import random and import string, then we write the following line and then right click on the file, run. We see our variable that we imported and here we see our whole alphabet including small and capital letters. Now we'll use random in string to guess our password. We specify the length of the password. We will write int and put write password length. You have to understand that 5 in quotation marks is not the same as 5 without quotation marks. The first is a string and the second is an integer. So to get an integer, we just specify int and then save it into a variable. Then we say my password equals string, which doesn't contain anything yet, and write for I in range password length, my password plus equals random.choice string.askeyletters. And now print your new password, my password. So what did we just do? We took the length of the password, we saved the variable, which is empty for now. We take, for example, 10 digits for a new password. To do that, we need a loop. In our case, this loop will run as many times as the user specifies, meaning the code inside the loop will be executed 10 times. The random choice function selects a random letter from the alphabet and adds that letter to my password. Then this code is executed the number of times the user has specified, and then your new password is ready. Let me show you how it works. Right-click, run, and for example, specify password length 5. Run and see 5 random letters. Let's try again and see some other letters. It works! Let's try 12 characters. Also works! We can make our password more complicated. In string, we set printable. This is all the characters that we can type on the keyboard. Now our password includes all the numbers and different unique characters. We try 12 characters, and the password now is much more complex. And that's how it works. Wow, that was hard. Three cool Python projects that you can now create on your own. Give me a like for this favor, subscribe, and don't forget the bell. In the next video, you'll learn 5 ways how to make a cool income from coding without getting a job, and to start writing your own code in the near future, watch my video Main Topics in the Python Language. There I gathered all the topics you need at the beginning of Master Python learning, divided them into 3 sections by level of complexity, and gave examples of code. My name is Steven White. I'm your guide to the world of Python programming. See you in the next videos, guys. Bye.